Bob Liggett has grown giant pumpkins in Circleville, Ohio for many years. He has the soil in his patch tested, then adds particular minerals and various nutrients, like molasses, to achieve optimum growing conditions in his well-tilled soil. Infrastructure, like fences and windbreaks, are established around the perimeter of the patch. Bob grows 3 or 4 pumpkins each season. PVC pipe hoops will be the backbone of small greenhouses to help warm the soil. In addition, heat tape coils are buried in the soil where the baby plants will be set out. Long before all of this, Bob has been studying the genealogy charts of various giant pumpkins to select the seeds for the plants he intends to grow. He uses seeds from his own winning pumpkins as well as seeds from other growers. The chosen seeds are gently sanded along their outer edges so they will open easier. The seeds are started in small pots in a homemade incubator to keep them at the optimum temperature of 85 degrees. It takes 2.5 to 3 days for the seedling to emerge. If the seed covering is still on the new leaves, it is gently removed by hand. Root shield and fertilizers are added to the pot to stabilize and maximize the new plant's root system. They will continue to grow under the cool and the warm temperature grow lights. Bob has become somewhat of a chemist, mixing up early growth fertilizers like root shield and a 10-52-10 compound plus seaweed. Now everything is ready. Time to dig a hole in the warmed up soil. Here is the new plant, healthy and ready for planting. Notice the third small leaf. The plant will grow in the opposite direction from that leaf. It's best to tilt the little plant toward its growth direction when setting it down in the hole. Mycorrhizal is spread around the root ball and the hole is filled up. A final drink of fertilizer tops off the planting. Keeping the plant warm will ensure a good start. The greenhouse once again becomes useful at this point, along with a heat lamp. Voila! 2 weeks later and the plant is growing nicely. Now it's time to shield it from the sun, as well as provide a windbreak. Work in the patch is ongoing, whether it be tilling up the soil, spreading dry fertilizer, or the constant weeding. Water for the growing plant is essential and is provided by a drip irrigation system. The drip tapes are fed from a long manifold with plenty of connections for each plant. The drip tapes are laid out in each plant as it grows larger. The main water point looks cumbersome, but it has a timer and a water meter to efficiently record the plant's daily intake. In addition, nutrients can be directly fed into the drip tapes too. The tips of the spreading lateral vines are held low and the entire stem is buried to build a more stabilized root structure. If a stem is damaged, it is treated with medicines or cut away completely. This leaf has been sunburned. With all the constant attention, the plant just keeps growing and growing. And now the part you've been waiting for. Sex in the pumpkin patch. A male blossom is chosen and the petals are removed from the flower. The chosen female flower, which has been capped off, is now uncapped. She opens up and shows off her reproductive lobes. The male stamen, full of pollen, is generously spread on those lobes, and the female flower is closed up and capped again. You don't want bees messing around with your genetics. In a day or two, the newly pregnant female will be showing off the tiny new pumpkin. The blossom petals are carefully removed, and the vine will start sending food into this new pumpkin. It is important to continue to care for the patch, especially the leaves. They are the manufacturers of the food that is sent through the stems to the growing pumpkin. More watering drip tapes are threaded into the expanding plant. And of course, weeding always continues. Now sun shields will help keep the main stem and the little leaves shaded. At this point, the tip will be growing 8 to 12 inches per day. Uh-oh, a problem is discovered at the main stem. The crack is held open with sticks, and hydrogen peroxide is used to treat this wound. Fans are placed to keep the stem dry. Fans also help dry out cracks that may develop in the pumpkins themselves. Another hazard to the plant are bugs of various sorts. Sprays are used as well as traps for things like cucumber beetles. Speaking of traps, you don't want mice making holes in the pumpkin either. As soon as the days begin to shorten, Bob puts up his grow lights to keep the leaves producing food for the now giant pumpkins. The Circleville Pumpkin Show is the third Wednesday in October, and by then the giant pumpkins are as ready as they ever will be. Time to take down the fences, the windbreaks, the water system, and the pumpkin shelters. Get the big ones primed for cutting. Despite a rainy afternoon, friends and neighbors arrived for the cutting ceremonies. Bob and Joe are really pleased with the result of their 5.5 months of work. Joe takes the first stem cut. The forklift moves into the patch with the lifting harness. The straps are ever so carefully adjusted, and the giant pumpkin is gently airborne and loaded onto the trailer. Morning finds Bob's best two pumpkins heading off to the early morning lineup for the weigh-off at the annual Circleville Pumpkin Show. This show has been held for more than 100 years and now attracts about 300,000 visitors each year. There are many pumpkin-themed treats among the exhibits, but the highlight of the show is the giant pumpkin weigh-off. This is the opening event. The lineup of the pumpkins stretches out along the street, allowing a closer look at all the competition. One by one, they are loaded off of their transport. They are weighed and then set up onto the exhibition stage. Finally, it's Bob's turn. The harness is ready. Here we go. Over to the certified scale. Be careful now. Everyone holds their breath while the scale master activates the result. Wow, 1,964 pounds. A new Circleville Pumpkin Show record and Bob and Joe's personal best ever. A trophy, of course, and a nice check for the giant 1,964 Liggett winning pumpkin. And congratulations to all the growers for their giant pumpkins. What happens next? Well, what does one do with a giant pumpkin after the show? First, you get the seeds out. Grandkids make great seed divers. Then it is up to your Halloween imagination.